Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding No Economy for Women, written by Sonalde Desai. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3, plus this is important for sociology and economics optional students. Now what is this editorial about? What is the central theme of this editorial? This editorial primarily deals with women work participation. Secondly, it deals with the importance accorded to the institution of family and how this impacts the employment aspect of women and men. And thirdly, this editorial is also about how the corporate class, how the work culture needs to be altered. Now, first of all, let us understand women work participation. Now, as far as women participation in the work is concerned, in countries like India and Pakistan, it is less. It is less in comparison to the Western countries. It is also less in comparison to the Southeast Asian nations. It is also less in comparison to China. It is also less in comparison to Sri Lanka. Now, why a nation like India is facing a scenario where the women are not able to join the work, where the women are not able to join the jobs, where the women, they contribute less by being part of formal employment? Now, before we understand the reasons behind the low employability of a woman, we must understand the difference between formal employment, formal sector, employability, and informal sector. And then we also need to differentiate and know about the household jobs. Now, as far as formal sector employability is concerned, it means somebody getting employed by a formal sector, by governmental institutions, by institutions in private sector that are formal. Formal means that they are being regulated. Formal means some institution paying the taxes to the government. Now, you have informal sector. Now, this is the sector that has a very high role to play in the Indian economy. Now, the women in the informal sector in India, they are more in number in comparison to formal sector. Now, the informal sector is also the agriculture sector. Informal sector is also a short span employment that the woman takes. Now, the problem is that when it comes to women, this household employment, this household job is not counted. What is generally counted is the formal sector employment and informal sector employment. And in informal sector employment, we have the agriculture as a sector. Now, this is one sector that has witnessed the decline in the women participation. Now, this has witnessed the decline in the women participation because of the changes that the economy is undergoing. Indian economy is shifting from agriculture to the service sector. We are jumping directly from the manufacturing sector. We don't have a strong manufacturing base. So there is a leap that we are taking. And this, in this leap that we are taking, women, they are not able to carry forward themselves. Women, they are not able to skill themselves properly. Women, they are not able to become part of the change. Now, why this is happening? Why this is unfolding? Now, this is unfolding because in India, a lot of importance is accorded to the institution of family. When you call a lot of importance to this institution, and when you call a lot of importance to the parenting aspect in which you groom your children, you actually tend to ignore your own career. So this editorial primarily talks about how the ultra importance that is being accorded to the institution of a family is resulting in the lower participation of the woman. And this is one of the reasons why the employability of a woman is less. And another important reason why the woman's employability is less, why the work participation, is because of the agriculture sector, decline in the agriculture sector. There is a decline in the agriculture sector, but this is not being replaced by the employment being generated in other sectors, in the secondary sector and in the tertiary sector. So both these sectors, they are not able to absorb the women's participation. Now, another reason is the security aspect. Now, the private institutions and the governmental institutions, they are not able to provide complete security for the women. Now, when they are not able to provide security to the women, they tend to feel repulsive. So they are not receptive to the idea of employability. This is another reason. Now, Sonalde Desai is also compared how the Indian system of working is different from the Scandinavian countries. Now, when it comes to the Scandinavian countries, men and women, they are truly equitable. They stand on the pedestal of equity. Now, because they stand on the pedestal of equity, they are at the same level. Women, they tend to focus more on their careers. Women, they are more concerned about their self-development, their self-esteem. They want to do something good in their professions. But this is something that is missing in the Indian culture because of the importance that we are according to the family. Now, how this thing can be taken care of? How we can increase, how we can nurture this gender dividend? Now, this is the new term that has been used by Sonalde Desai. This is a very important term. Gender dividend. Now, this gender dividend can be used, this gender dividend can be focused on. This gender dividend can be used to extract more for the economy if our workplaces will become conscious about this family institution. Now the working places, now the work laws, the labor laws, they are actually mute, they are actually silent about this family aspect. They are silent about according equality to men and women. And this is one of the reasons why the women work participation is less. Now, this year, there was also an essay asked in UPSC, if development is not engendered, it is endangered. Now, what it actually means? It means that if you will not be provide equity to men and women, in that case, your economy will suffer. Your development will be partial. Your development will be pseudo. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact us at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in joining the offline and online classes, and if you're interested in buying the video classes packages. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.